Of contractors in Kura, we believe in quality work, we believe in quality production of work. And I want to say this on live TV to all our contractors: if you do short work, you do work not as per our specifications, we will just terminate the contract. We have done it before, so we don't entertain contractors who do not perform.
Asante. Maybe we can a lawmaker. And as a leader, is two things. One, anybody who does work below standard, by law, if you look at the even the roads laws, look at the Public Procurement and Disposal Act, they must be surcharged and blacklisted. So we will not have a situation where somebody is doing shoddy work, being allowed to continue doing work. You know, it beats purpose. That is taxpayers' money. And instead of doing one road 10 times, we'd rather do one road once, but be done properly. On the issue of where the contractor comes from, you know, for me, I think it's a place where we've reached as a country. When we say, Apana, a Kenyan cannot do this, let's get a Chinese. We need to also start believing in ourselves. It cannot be, and even, you know, in many areas that we say, Apana, Mzungu ndo afanye, Chinese ndo afanye. If it's contractor, and I'm told the one there is also Chinese, I have no problem with the country they are from. But when do we start also believing in ourselves and raising our standards as people? There are also Chinese contractors who probably have done substandard work in many places. And there are Kenyan contractors who have done substandard work. Let's see them as contractors. Let's not think that a Kenyan or an African cannot do work the standard that a Chinese can do. And those who have been doing bad work and giving us, as Kenyans, a bad name, shame on them. Wacha kutuharibia jina. We can do it. If tomorrow I say, oh, I want a Chinese journalist instead of Kenyan journalist because they take better. We've been fighting this issue. We've been saying Kenyans can drive SGR. We want the Chinese to stop driving it. We want Kenyans to drive it. We must believe in ourselves as a country. So whether you're from China or from Kenya, you must do work to a certain standard. If you don't do it to that standard, you must be surcharged. And we must give our local contractors also an opportunity. But anyway, I'm not in the procurement process. I don't know how they choose. The DG is anonymous. Maybe you can address that issue. But
and we thank all the leaders who have made this to happen, our security operators. We, as the SACOs in Mweki, my name is Sam Kago, and as we have said, or the senators have said, that we have agreed, we shall resume, because as from now, the graders will be on the road, we shall go there. As the graders start working, we shall also go back and resume in ferrying the passengers back at home. We regret everything. Ours was just unhonest, and we regret anything that has happened, and I believe with our MP and our senator, they will push even for the better, for the betterment of the road to be done in the proper way, and we appreciate, and we shall resume our services. And, yes.
Aye. My condolences to the family who lost their young man, and also to the other, to the entire Kasarani resident. It was quite sad, and we also wish well the police officers who were injured yesterday. Kasarani Mweki Road, for the last 20 years, it has been in a mess. We would basically say the road had no base. And it's quite unfortunate that the road, the pathetic way, or the road, the way it's bad, has been used by some other maybe sections in a way to maybe for them to gain mileage. But that's notwithstanding. We are quite happy because Kura has committed itself, and of course the PDU, to make sure that the road will be repaired until we get the upcoming project, which will be doed from Jiro all the way to committee. And we hope that in future we will not have such issues again, because Kasarani happens to be quite large, and we need a lot of development there. But what is needed right now, and it's, with a lot of urgency, it's Kasarani Mweki Road to be repaired, the 2 kilometers. And I know at least if we keep our word and we do the needful, the resident will have no problem. Sorry, because at least Whatever happened yesterday, it was quite sad. But it's quite unfortunate the protest went on, but other people maybe who don't wish people well, they did what they did, and there was a lot of disorder yesterday, but we hope at least from this afternoon there will be order, and the public transport will resume as they have committed, the circles have committed, and we have urged them as leaders to make sure that we have peace and we have soberness within the estates, because we don't want to see what happened yesterday or for the last 3 days since Monday. It has not been okay within Kasarani. So I'll urge everybody, let's maintain peace, because anybody who maybe has other issues may want to take advantage of the situation. And as a resident of Kasarani, we are not even aware of what is happening. So we just hope that at least all the sectors, all the topics which are involved, everybody to do his or her part so that we see that the road is actually repaired.
Asante. Asante sana mheshimiwa.
And for Nairobi alone, we knew after the rains the roads will be banned, and we have committed 1.7 million Kenya shillings in Nairobi. I just want to confirm what our senator has said. That money is committed. We have contractors already on the ground. And the one for Kasarani Mwiki Road, we knew that we required more resources. That is why we actually even budgeted for it separately. And we have 300 million allocated for that road. And what we want to do is not to do the kind of a small maintenance works we do. We do full construction of the road to ensure that it is sustainable even for the next over 10 years. So I'm assuring the public, the people of Nairobi, and the people of Kenya at large, in all towns, we have plans to ensure that after the rains, we will address the damage which has been caused with the resources which you have. Thank you.
Thank you.